Hey Chloe, I heard you don't like the TV show Miraculous Ladybug. Could you tell me why?
It's because of this super lame loser named Marinette Dupin Chang. She's this horrible girl in my class, and she hates me. She's getting everyone up against me, and she-
Maybe this Marinette girl isn't entirely to blame?
No, she is entirely to blame. Okay, maybe I blame someone else. Miraculous Ladybug is a French cartoon filled with a lot, and I mean a lot of characters. Characters that are memorable, forgettable, lovable, and dislikable. First of all, I still kind of like Marinette. Marinette is a really nice person and does a lot of nice things to help people. But she also does really, really bad, unforgivable things. In this video, I'm going to talk about the bad side of Marinette, because they really disturb me a lot. She ended up being my least favorite character in the whole show because of the bad things that she has done. Because they're just so unforgivable. And I think her bad stuff is outweighing the good stuff as the series goes on. She's getting worse and worse. But I'm not saying, I am most definitely not saying, she's the worst character. Second of all, if you love Marinette, if you think that she's the best character in the whole show, then I can respect that 100%. Feel free to share your thoughts down below, because hearing different opinions is a lot of fun. With that said, I think Marinette is a terribly written protagonist, and I think she's getting worse and worse, and here are the reasons why. Marinette Dupin Chang, or should I say Marinette Bread Chang, is a teenage girl who attends Kaylin's class. She's Chloe's rival, Lila's enemy, and the bestest friend of the most annoying character in the entire show.
Because our school is the only school that uses that book!
She is friends with a model, her uncle is the greatest chef in the world, her BFF owns the most popular blog in the whole city, she is acknowledged by the most famous fashion designer, she babysits the daughter of a famous news reporter, she is an awesome gamer, her parents own the best bakery in Paris, and her parents love and support her unconditionally. Wow. Now that was a lot. Is Marinette problematic?
Hello.
She's problematic in my most definitely not invalid opinion. I mean, how is being an obsessive stalker who doesn't move on from someone not problematic? To prove my point, let's take a look at the episodes where Marinette goes too far, and I mean too far, with her obsessiveness over Adrian. Copycat. In that episode, it is revealed that Marinette made a whole chart dedicated to Adrian's private daily schedule. Like who in the right mind would do such a thing? Gigantitan. This episode is all about Marinette and her best friends making a plan to help Marinette satisfy her obsessive desire to hang out with Adrian. Not only is Marinette problematic, but her friends are problematic as well. Her friends are terrible. In order for them to be not terrible, they should discourage Marinette's obsessiveness over Adrian and encourage her to move on, because this is not healthy. What you're doing is not healthy, Marinette. You want to know what is healthy?
Excuse me, but why do we need a plan? I mean, can't Marinette just go up to Adrian and ask him out?
But no, they just had to encourage her to keep on obsessing over Adrian because it's fun. Oh god, I'm so glad my friends are not like that. I think Milene and Tornado are the only realistic friends of Marinette.
She knows everything about Adrian. Creepy, no?
Yeah, it's so romantic!
At the end of the episode, I was actually very relieved that Adrian didn't get to hang out with Marinette, and he didn't get to ride her home. I just want her to get away from him because she's just so... You should go with Kagami, man. At least she's not a stalker. Oni-chan. In this episode, after Adrian goes home with Lila, Marinette tries to climb over to watch over Adrian. Okay. A fireman shows up, and instead of teaching her a lesson on how wrong it is to stalk on people, he helped her climb over so she can stalk on Adrian. Dude, why did you help her commit a crime? Don't tell me. Don't tell me. Don't tell me you feel her pain. Or maybe not, because maybe Marinette was just guilt-tripping him by crying. Oh, why are you crying, Marinette? Because you can't climb over to stalk on your crush? You need some help. Party Crasher. In this stupid-ass episode, Marinette becomes so fucking obsessed over Adrian's party that she abandons her friends, dresses up as a dumbass biker man to get in the party. This episode just makes her look so selfish and so pathetic. I honestly wouldn't feel anything if they completely delete this episode from existence. I'm being serious. This episode is just that bad. It's not funny. It's cringy, it's annoying, and it's really stupid.
Hi there, it's me, Marino, your neighbor. I heard there was a party going on here, guys only, so I'd like to come too, because I'm a guy. In fact, it's hard for me to walk with all these guy muscles of mine.
I've put my trust in you.
The Puppeteer 2. When Adrian pretended to be a wax statue to prank Marinette,
Eternity sounds like a long time.
So, I think this is trying to imply that Marinette loves Adrian so much that if she sees a wax statue of Adrian, she's willing to kiss it. If that is not what you call obsessive, creepy, and problematic, then I don't know what the actual hell that is. Cat Blanc. In this episode, she snuck into Adrian's room to give him her letter. Dude, you're doing something so illegal right now, do you know that? All because she couldn't wait for Adrian to come home. Wait, there he is right now! All you really had to do was wait! So she snuck inside his room like a real criminal and gives him her letter. But before she does that, she does this.
Adrian's.
This kept me up all night, man. I'm worried about Adrian. He's friends with a freaking obsessive stalker. He's friends with a criminal. And people say Chloe is bad? You don't know what real bad is, man. So overall, our main hero is nothing but a creepy, obsessive stalker that still hasn't moved on from Adrian in the end. Because the guy who made this show doesn't think that stalking on people is bad. He thinks it's funny! The real reason why I think this is problematic is because not only is it so wrong, but it just does not work. Let me explain. I'm actually okay if major characters act like horrible people if it makes sense. I'm not one of those people who is immediately going to hate a character if he or she has a terrible behavior. I've always loved Trevor. Yes, Trevor is a psychopath, but it actually works because his behavior actually makes sense, and it's explored really well. His upbringing was just so terrible.
Look, this is all I've got, alright? I had a tough upbringing. My daddy was not nice to me, okay? And look, Deborah, I love you, and I love you too, Floyd. Why can't we all just be together, huh? You can have Mondays through Thursdays, you can have the weekends, all right? I know that's not normal, but in this crazy, crazy world, is normal so good, huh? Look, Deborah, Floyd, will you marry me?
What? The same thing can be said for Chloe. I'm okay with her being a bully because it was explained and explored. The same thing can also be said for Asuka Langley. My point is, I think it's okay for a major character who gets a lot of screen time to act like a horrible human being if the toxic behavior is explained and explored. And if it is explained and explored, then it works. I'm not saying that if their horrible behaviors are explained, they're automatically good people. I'm saying that if their horrible behaviors are explained, then they are automatically decently written characters. If a character's toxic behavior is not and will never be explained, I'm totally fine with that. As long as the character is minor and does not appear often in the show. Just take a look at this guy from Invincible. I forgot his name. His toxic behavior was never explained, but I'm totally fine with that. Because he only appeared in this show a total of 3 times. Never again. And it's also fine if the toxic behavior of a major character was never explained if it's meant to be a mystery. Just take a look at Joker from The Dark Knight. Even though that his devilish behavior wasn't explained very well, I still love him. Because he's meant to be a mysterious character. His entire motivation was all meant to be a mystery. And it worked really well.
Some men aren't looking for anything logical, like money. They can't be bought, bullied, reasoned, or negotiated with. Some men just want to watch the world burn.
This does not work at all because it's a really big part of the series and it doesn't make any logical sense. Her bad behavior was explored a lot of times, but never explained. And I don't really think her behavior is meant to be a mystery. That not only makes her a bad person, but it also makes her a badly written character. Marinette Dupin-Cheng is a problematic person and a problematic character. And now you might be saying, "Oh, Cyrus, chill out, dude, it's meant to be funny, okay?" Okay, if you guys think this is funny, then good for you. Humor is subjective. And in my own subjective opinion, I don't find this funny. I find this to be really annoying and creepy. But even though that I know this is meant to be a joke, I still think it's garbage. Because in the end, it doesn't make any logical sense. The only thing that explains her obsessiveness is this. But that's not enough for me. I need more. I need more information than just this. Why does she love him so much? Does he remind her of someone else she used to know? That would be a really interesting backstory and a really good explanation to why she's so obsessed with him. But for real, why does she love Adrian so much? We'll get to that later. You know it's a big problem when a character that you're supposed to be rooting for is a jerk that does a lot of terrible things for no good reason. Here are the episodes where Marinette Dupin-Cheng acts like an asshole with no logical sense. Volpina. In this episode, we are introduced to Lila Rossi, often considered the most hated character in the entire show. She's nothing but a compulsive liar. Although I actually think she's interesting, I want to know more of her. Why is she lying all the time? I want to know. Anyways, let's get to the elephant scene. Lila lies to Adrian so much that it triggered Marinette to use her superpowers and publicly humiliate her in front of Adrian. Okay, Lila deserves that. She deserves to have some consequences for her actions because what she did was so terrible. She deserves to be punished. She deserves that. But I don't really think this is the way to do it. I honestly don't think Marinette did the right thing here. In defense of Lila Rossi, specifically in this episode, Lila didn't really do anything wrong. Well, actually, yes, she did do something wrong. She lied so much to Adrian, but she didn't do anything wrong towards Marinette. She didn't tell Adrian that he should stay away from Marinette. She didn't tell him that Marinette's superhero costume looks like shit. It does look like shit, though. She didn't say anything involving Marinette's reputation. Hell, she didn't even do anything to put Adrian in danger. She just said that she is a descendant of a superheroine so she could impress Adrian. All she ever wanted was to get close to Adrian. And what did she do? She abused her superpowers and humiliated Lila, not because Adrian was in grave danger, but because she just wanted Lila to get away from Adrian. Basically, she just did a truly selfish thing.
It was an emergency.
Yeah, if by emergency you mean jealousy.
Let me say it again. Lila does deserve some consequences for her actions, but I don't think this is the way to do it. I personally think that it's best for Marinette to just leave her alone. If you want to embarrass her or if you want to expose her, then do it when you're Marinette, not Ladybug. Don't use your powers for personal gain, man. That's not cool. Isn't Ladybug a parody of Spider-Man? You know, a superhero character that has a core value that says, "With great power comes great responsibility." You have great powers, that's for sure. But where's the great responsibility? If you are a parody of Spider-Man, then you're doing a great job being a terrible one. Because you're not funny, and you're not really a good role model for children. Now, if you think that it's best for Marinette to embarrass Lila because it's a lot more satisfying than Marinette doing nothing, that's okay, but I don't think you will ever understand why I don't like this scene. I don't like this scene because for me, it doesn't make any rational sense. Marinette abused her superpowers because she wanted to get Lila away from Adrian. Why? Because she loves him so much. If this show really wants me to believe that Marinette loves Adrian so goddamn much, then they should have done more than just that. They need to make this more believable. Let's take a look at Queen Wasp. Why did Chloe do that? Because she wanted to impress her mother. She wanted her mom, the person who has neglected Chloe her whole life, to love her.
I'm exceptional too!
The only exceptional thing about you, my dear, is your mother.
This scene is very well done because it actually made sense and had a lot of emotions to it. Sure, it makes Chloe look like a terrible person, but at least it makes her look terrible in a rational way. And that's a good thing because it made rational sense. Rational sense. Keep that in mind.
Keep that in mind.
But this one sucks because it just doesn't make any rational sense at all. And it truly makes Ladybug look like a terrible person with no good reason. She did that because she thinks that she's losing the love of her life.
How's Adrian supposed to be the love of her life if you can't even talk to him?
Tiki, stay out of sight.
She did that not because she needed to, but because she wanted to. And that's just very selfish. And also, Marinette, Adrian is not your property. He's not your boyfriend. He's not your husband. So why the hell are you always acting like he is? Adrian doesn't belong to anyone. So stop acting like he belongs to you because that just makes you look like an asshole. Not letting other girls to be nearby Adrian? She won't let anyone touch Adrian because she loves him that much. How come? How come she loves him so much? When she barely knows the guy. I don't freaking know.
Hey, what was that all about? I mean, were you kinda harsh with her?
Well, looks like you got something you wanna say, huh? You got something you need to say?
I don't put up with lies, especially when they're about me.
Fuck off.
What is with you, Ladybug?
Antibug. In this episode, Chloe got akumatized for the first time. Why? Because Ladybug pissed her off. Why did she do that? She did that because she simply does not like Chloe. It is truly, in my opinion, the most selfish thing she has ever done in her whole life. Reflect Doll. In this episode, Julika decided to volunteer to be Marinette's model for her stereotypical French outfit, so she can get character development. During their photoshoot, Julika becomes so shy that she started talking without making her lips touch.
Just not feeling that.
Is this some sort of syndrome that I don't know about? So, instead of encouraging Julika that she is a beautiful girl and that she can do it, what did Marinette say?
This is something I should do myself after all.
Wow. Why did she say that? So she can be with Adrian! I honestly think the best thing for Marinette to do is, like I said, encourage Julika that she is beautiful and that she can do this. Instead of saying, I can do this myself and Julika, you can go fuck off because we don't need you anymore. Because that just makes you look so selfish. What's even worse is that Alia becomes so fucking obsessed over Marinette's attempt to model with Adrian. Alia. The way she acts in this episode just makes me want to fucking kill her. Can I do that, please? Later, when she transforms, she turns into the biggest asshole in the whole wide world, known as Lady Noir.
Very effective, Mr. Bug.
But I thought...
May I remind you that the Lucky Charm doesn't just give you an object to defeat the villain with? You actually have to figure out exactly how to use it to win the battle, using your head!
Why did she do that? Because it's funny. No, it's not funny. And here's the reason why. Why is Cat Noir acting funny most of the time? Because Adrian wants to feel free from his horrible life. But what about Lady Noir? Why is she acting like that? Because she wants to purposefully insult and bully Mr. Bug. There's a good reason for Cat Noir to act like that, but Lady Noir doesn't. If you make Marinette act like that in a completely irrational way, all while perpetuating feminism, then I'm not going to like that character. Because that just makes Lady Noir look like the biggest narcissistic asshole in the world of superheroes.
I just need to use my lucky-
No, wait!
Why'd you do that?
The lucky charm doesn't just give you what you want. Beginner's luck. You actually have to figure out exactly how to use it to win the battle, using your head.
Look, if you're so good at this, then why don't you just do it all by yourself, you narcissistic bitch? I'm not trying to be insulting. I'm being real here. You really are a narcissistic bitch. My point is, this is not funny, this is insulting. One of the most insulting things I have ever seen in this show so far. And I most definitely don't ship these two. Get away from him, you skank.
You bet! I'm the cunning, funny, and ultra-charming Lady Noir!
That's it, Marinette! Go to the principal's office!
Anime Maestro. This episode, ignoring this guy, is about Marinette and Chloe teaming up to bully and humiliate Kagami. Why? Because they think that Adrian is being kidnapped. I'm not making this up.
Marinette? Surely you're not gonna team up with Chloe? I'm just stopping Kagami from kidnapping Adrian and taking him off to Japan. He's too nice to see what she's really up to.
Oh my god!
Ikari Gozen. This episode is about Marinette trying to sabotage Kagami's chance of winning the dumbass friendship game. All for what? Adrian.
Hello.
What really bothers me about this episode is the fact that she still didn't move on from Adrian, even though, canonically, she finally knows that Adrian is in love with another girl. So this episode meant nothing? Huh? Or did that episode take place after this episode? According to my research, the answer is no. Miraculous Ladybug's timeline is such an inconsistent mess. Desperada. In this episode, before facing Desperada, Ladybug... Ladybug had the balls to say this.
Still no cat. Come to think of it, we're okay without him.
Wow. Just wow. I really hope she didn't mean that. I mean, after everything you've done with Cat Noir, after everything he has done for you, after he puts his trust on you countless times, after he confesses to you countless times, after everything you've been through with Cat Noir, you say that?
Come to think of it, we're okay without him.
Do I even need to explain further to why she's an absolute asswipe? I don't think I need to because this says it all. Bottom line, I think Ladybug is a jerk for most of the show, and I think it's a bad thing that she's a jerk. And I might be saying, oh Cyrus, you hate Marinette but you love Chloe, Chloe is a jerk too, you know. Okay, just let me explain. I'm not bothered by the fact that Chloe is a jerk, because Chloe being a jerk makes rational sense. But I'm bothered by the fact that Marinette is a jerk because it doesn't make any rational sense. And it's really difficult for me to root for her because she acts like a jerk most of the time with no logical sense. She's not an angel, she's a jerk. You know what? I'm actually okay with Marinette being a jerk if it makes logical sense. But most of the time, when she acted like a jerk, I hated it. Because there is no rational sense behind her being a jerk. You wanna know what's even worse than being a jerk? A character facing consequences after doing something terrible makes me want to sympathize and respect him or her. But if a character doesn't face consequences after doing something so unforgivable and instead gets a really awesome reward in the end, just makes me want to distinguish all of my respect for the character. And Marinette is exactly that. A character that doesn't face consequences. Here are the episodes where Marinette does something so terrible but ultimately didn't get punished and instead got an awesome reward in the end. Copycat. In this episode, Marinette willingly stole Adrian's cell phone, all because she wants to delete the stupid-ass message she accidentally sent to Adrian. You know, I honestly think it would have been better, and it would make more sense, if Marinette and Adrian just talked about the message and be like, Adrian, Marinette, would you mind explaining this to me? Is this supposed to be a prank? Oh no, that was just a complete accident. I actually wanted to call you, but it went out of control, and I accidentally pressed the wrong button that ended up being sent to you. I'm so sorry, Adrian. Was that so hard? And besides, why were you so afraid about Adrian finding out? What you said in the recorded message is not that bad. You didn't send a death threat or anything like that. You just said something so laughable. That's it. You think Adrian will call the cops on you? Dude, just freaking reason with him because Adrian is that type of person. He's a reasonable guy. He's not like Chloe. I thought you know that, since you stalk on him so goddamn much. Just do what Mordecai did in Butt Dial.
Dude, just come clean already.
Okay, look.
So after a while, she successfully deleted the message and plans on giving back Adrian's phone and admitting what she has done. Will she actually come clean? Will she actually face the consequence of her action? Well, the answer is no, because after she conveniently returned his cell phone without being noticed, the dumbest shit in the entire history of Miraculous Ladybug transpired.
I already looked in here 1,000 times.
You need some time off. Hey, I know. Let's go to the movies tonight.
Hey, dudes. Mind if a few friends tag along?
Sure thing.
So instead of facing the consequences of her unforgivably wrongdoing, she gets a really awesome reward instead. She gets to go to the movies with Adrian and her best friend, along with Nino. Wow. After committing a literal crime, she doesn't get to be punished. All because of Nino randomly bringing up the topic of them going to the movies together. It is truly the dumbest shit this series has ever pulled. No exaggeration, no argument, because nothing, and I mean nothing, can compare to this stupid-ass scene. And I honestly think they should have never thought of this scene in the first place, because it's just so very wrong. Is this supposed to teach kids a lesson that says, remember kids, it's okay to steal cell phones from other people. You won't get punished as long as you return it without being noticed. The one who came up with this scene, I just want to ask you something. Do you know what prison feels like? Roger Cop. In this episode, Marinette was being accused of Grand Theft Bracelet. Marinette defends herself by saying that since she is being accused of stealing the bracelet, everyone in the entire class should be accused as well. Now that is communism. But wait, no, it's not communism because she wants everyone to be accused, but not Adrian.
Oh, not Adrian. I mean, why would he need to steal a bracelet? If anyone's guilty, it's gotta be one of us.
Wow. Everyone started to get angry at Marinette, and will she face the consequence of her action? No, because conveniently, the villain arrives to interrupt the punishment. And that gives her a good excuse to run away from her consequence and hide so she can transform and save the day. Damn. Now that's pathetic writing. The reward she got is that she didn't get to face the consequences of her actions. So fucking pathetic.
Lesson learned.
Shut up, the mime. After deleting Alia's Ladyblog video, by complete accident, Marinette attempts to recreate it to avoid the consequences of her actions. It was a massive failure. In the end, she told Alia the truth, but everything is fine because Alia knew that that was going to happen? You let her get away with it? Dude, you need to teach her that what she did was so wrong and that she should never do it again. Otherwise, she will do it again. And you call yourself an amazing BFF?
Not gonna happen, because last year, you didn't have your amazing BFF.
Shut up.
No, we're cool. Besides, I uploaded the video onto my Ladyblog before I showed it to you.
I'm so lucky to have a friend like you.
So basically, she said she is so lucky to have a friend who doesn't get angry at her. Right? Is that what she meant? Later, she abuses her superpowers to do an interview with Alia. She really is that desperate to avoid consequences, huh? Also, what she did was just so wrong. Like I said, abuse of power, but not only that, she also persuaded her best friend to act in one's favor in a very dishonest way. That is what you call bribery. I think I'm misunderstanding this scene. If I am, then could you guys please correct me down in the comments below? Because I really can't see this and think it's anything other than abuse of power and bribery. Ikari Gozen. In this episode, Marinette made a complete fool out of Kagami.
I can't believe you're stuck with Kagami. Hang in there, girl, and don't worry, I'm sure you'll figure out a way to lose. Catch you later!
Mwah. Wow. After being embarrassingly fooled, instead of smashing Marinette's cell phone with passionate rage, Kagami just goes with it. I just want to hug you right now, Kagami. So after that, she goes to Marinette, and will Marinette face the consequences of her action? Dude, of course the answer is no, because that's the whole point of this topic. She didn't face the consequences because conveniently, this happened.
Hello?
Kagami, where are you? You were supposed to wait for me at home.
Kagami's mom called, and Marinette goes to Kagami to let her know that she is in gigantic trouble. Instead of punching Marinette in the face, which would be so believable and satisfying and realistic, she smiles. Kagami sees that Marinette is trying to defend her and smiles. No consequences, awesome reward. After defeating Ikari Gozen, they officially become friends.
I was wrong about you, Marinette.
What? Dude, no. You're not wrong. You were right all along about Marinette. She's an asshole. Kagami ended up being her friend because she believes that Marinette is her true friend.
It's not important to have lots of friends. What matters is that the ones you have are true friends.
True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. True friends. Truth.
There are two things that I learned from this dumbass episode. Kagami is an amazing person, and Marinette is not. And the other lesson I learned from this episode is Marinette did not face her consequences and got- Shut up! And got a reward instead. Well, I- Shut up! I said, shut up! Shut up! Well, I guess the only consequence that she faced is she felt so bad.
I feel so bad.
Aw, you feel so bad, Marinette Dupin-Chang, huh? You feel so bad, huh? Go fuck yourself. Why in the ever-living shit would they write Marinette this way? Make her a character who does a lot of terrible things, but ultimately didn't get punished in the end. How am I supposed to root for a character like that? How am I supposed to respect her? How am I supposed to feel sympathy for Marinette since she doesn't get punished for her worst deeds? That's why I think Chloe is a much better character than Marinette. Yes, Chloe does a lot of terrible things, but at least she faces the consequences of her actions. Even Adrian faces consequences, as well as the rest of these guys. Most of these guys. Marinette, the one who we are supposed to be rooting for the entire show, does not face the consequences of her worst actions. Just because she's the main character, that doesn't automatically mean that she's allowed to not face consequences. I mean, how else is she going to learn from her mistakes if she doesn't get punished for them? I think I have the answer. She does learn her lessons, but the way she learns them, in my opinion, is so lazily executed. Let's take a look at Roger Cop. How did Marinette learn her lesson here? Not by getting punished, but by merely talking to Tiki. Frightingale. How did Marinette learn her lesson here? By talking to Tiki. Ikariko Zen. The same thing goes here. She learned her lesson by talking to Tiki. Tiki, what in God's name is her purpose? Why does she exist in this show? I think her purpose is, Marinette, don't do this. Marinette, don't do that. Marinette, you should do this. Marinette, you should do that. Marinette, did you know that this means this and this means that? And Marinette, did you know that Clommies are fucking stupid? Tiki's entire purpose of existence is, I think, to give Marinette superpowers, teach her lessons, and give exposition. That's it. Unpopular opinion, I think Tiki sucks. Because she is absolutely nothing but a plot device. Most of the time. Plague is way better because he has more character and more personality. Plague is someone who's carefree, easygoing, and likes to eat cheese. Specifically Camembert. He is also someone who is competent of perceiving his mistakes and doing the right thing.
You're a selfish being and a total coward!
I am not a coward and I'm not selfish either. But maybe this Adrian boy has some yummy Camembert left.
What about Tiki? Tiki is nice. Very, very nice. And she loves teaching Marinette lessons about stuff.
You know what happens once you use your lucky charm. You only have minutes before-
I turn back, I know.
Oh, Marinette, you really need to get your priorities in order. How's Adrian supposed to be the love of your life if you can't even talk to him? Great job, Marinette. I'm sure you'll find a way to make it right.
Marinette? Surely you're not gonna team up with Chloe.
Tiki, fucking go away and let her learn her lessons by herself. She needs to grow up. Another reason why I think Chloe has better writing than Marinette. The way Chloe learned her lesson in Queen Wasp was executed very well. It's not fast, it's not forced, it feels natural.
Ladybug? Cat Noir? I'm sorry.
But this?
No! You were right, Tiki! I never should have waited this long!
Shut the hell up, Marinette! Bottom line, I think Tiki sucks because she's mostly boring, and the fact that they mostly use her as a lesson-learned device for Marinette is indeed lazy writing. There are some episodes where she actually became interesting, but most of the time, she's boring and uninteresting. And not to mention, her voice just makes me want to fucking kill myself.
Well, for one, what if someone finds out you're Ladybug? And two, what if someone finds out you're Ladybug?
Unlike Plague. But hey, if you actually love Tiki, then good for you. As a bonus, let's talk about Adrianette. Adrianette is garbage. You're done? Okay. Adrianette is garbage. I thought you're done. To fully explain why, let me answer this question. Marinette, why do you love Adrian so much? What did he ever do to you? To my knowledge, all he did was say sorry for the chewing gum, and he offered Marinette his umbrella, while looking cool. That's it. That's the entire reason why this ship existed. That's the entire reason why she loves him. This is not what you call love, dude. This is what you call lust. Marinette doesn't really love Adrian. She just loves him because she thinks he's handsome and really nice. No other reason. As far as my knowledge goes, she doesn't love him as a person. She just loves his image. That's not love, that is lust. If this is not lust, then I don't know what the hell this is. Marinette really needs to knock it off and just start loving herself. Because you know what they say? If you want to be loved, you gotta love yourself. Marinette moving on from Adrian and starting to love herself would be character development. But no, that can't happen because that would be detrimental to the series. Okay, fine. Don't move on from Adrian. Don't get character development. Because God forbid any character from this show getting real development. Lady Noir is better than Adrianette. The reason why is because that ship actually makes sense. Adrian loving Ladybug makes sense to me. Putting Chloe and the rest of his friends aside, Ladybug is literally his first and one and only true friend that he has ever had in his entire life. That's why he loves her so much. She is literally everything to him. She makes him feel like someone whose life is worth living. For the first time ever, he finally has a healthy friendship. Marriquette. Everyone loves Marriquette. Me too, bro. I think this is the best compared to these. Because Marriquette is the least toxic, the most interesting, and the most healthy because 1. Adrian can finally talk to Marinette without making her stammer all the time. 2. Marinette can finally see Cat Noir's soft side. And 3. They both can act like their real selves to each other. Unlike in these ships, Marriquette is overall amazing. If only we get to see this more often. Adrigami. I like Adrigami. Because in that ship, Kagami actually likes Adrian as a person. She treats him the way he is meant to be treated. A normal human being. It's way better than Adrianette, because it's more healthy and it makes more sense. The same thing can be said for Lucanette. But I kind of don't like and care about Lucanette because how am I supposed to like it, let alone care about it, when I barely know anything about this guy? Clodrian. Unpopular opinion, I like Clodrian. I think I'm the only one here who likes this ship. Sure, it's not really the best ship, but it's honestly way better and more believable than Adrianette. Why does Chloe love Adrian? Chloe loves Adrian because he is somehow the one and only person who sees the real goodness inside her. She's happy every time Adrian's around because she sees him as the guardian angel she needs right now. That's why she loves Adrian. Adrian is Chloe's guardian angel. Adrian is Chloe's escape. Adrian is Chloe's reason to live. And don't ever forget about the fact that they've known each other since they were little. Anyway, my point is Adrianette is for me garbage compared to these ships because it just doesn't make any rational sense. It's very uncomfortable and it's not cute at all. It's very annoying and creepy. These ships are way better because for me, they're a lot more believable, less toxic, and they make more sense. If it doesn't make sense, it's automatically garbage.
That's right. I like you a little bit, just like a regular human being. Can somebody throw me into a vat of wax right now, please?
It would be my honor, Marinette. In conclusion, Marinette Dupin Chang, or Marinette Bread Chang, is a terrible protagonist for the series because there is absolutely no reason for her to be that terrible. Marinette is someone who I'm supposed to be rooting for. Unlike Chloe, Marinette is someone who I'm supposed to be loving. Unlike Chloe, Marinette is someone who doesn't have terrible parents and role models. Unlike Chloe, Marinette is someone who is nice. Unlike Chloe! But the fact that Marinette ended up being my least favorite, and the fact that Chloe ended up being my second most favorite, blows my goddamn mind.
I know, I'm breathtaking.
The fact that she does a lot of unforgivable things with no logical sense, and the fact that she didn't get punishment, and the fact that she doesn't really develop, just makes me want to eliminate all of my respect for her. She's losing a lot of my respect. But not all of it. At least, not yet. Mean people don't and will never deserve a Miraculous. Yeah, well, Marinette steals cell phones. Marinette abuses her superpowers for personal gain. Marinette bribes her own best friend. Marinette passionately stalks on Adrian. Marinette studies Adrian's personal private daily schedule. Marinette doesn't give Cat Noir a single chance. Marinette downright admits that she doesn't need Cat Noir. And Marinette made a fool out of Kagami. She's annoying, she's narcissistic, she's problematic, she does a lot of terrible things, and worst of all, she doesn't face the consequences for a lot of her actions. And the way she learns her lessons is so lazily executed. Adrian should have been the main character because 1. I feel more sympathy for him than Marinette. 2. His importance to the central plot is gigantic, compared to Marinette. And 3. He has better writing than Marinette. But that's not saying much. Adrian, you deserve better. You deserve better writing, and you deserve better than Marinette. Go with Kagami, or maybe Chloe. I don't care. Either way, way better than Marinette. Focusing more on Adrian would have been so interesting and amazing. But instead, we get to focus on Marinette babysitting Manon!
Fucking shit!
Why do we have to focus on Marinette babysitting? Why do we have to focus so much on Marinette, but not Adrian? Why do we have to focus so much on the less interesting character, but not the more interesting character? Tell me why!
Tell me why!
Imagine if the main character of Star Wars is not Luke Skywalker. Imagine if all of the focus was not put on Luke Skywalker, but instead it's on a random guy. A random, normal, annoying guy. Marinette is just getting way too much screen time in my opinion. Give her a break, man, and give someone else the spotlight. Like Adrian. Look, I'm not saying that Marinette shouldn't be the main character anymore, and I am most definitely not saying that boys are better than girls. I'm saying, please give Adrian or any of these guys more focus in the further future. Because I think they deserve it. They're all really interesting and deserve an episode of their own. Seriously. Just because Marinette is the main character, that doesn't mean she automatically deserves all of the spotlight and the glory. Unless if the show is all about Marinette and Marinette only. But it's not. It's about Adrian too. Miraculous Tales of Ladybug and Cat Noir. Let me say it again, and Cat Noir. Back then, I loved Marinette. But as it goes on, she just keeps getting worse and worse and worse. I am most definitely not saying that Marinette needs to be perfect. I'm just saying I don't like the way she's written, because most of the time, it doesn't make any logical, rational sense. The only reason Marinette isn't a dogshit character is because she looks like Mahatma Gandhi compared to a character that I'm going to be talking about in the further future. Because while Marinette is my least favorite character in the whole show, she still isn't the worst character. The biggest compliment that I can give Marinette is at least she is not boring. While I hate the way she's written, at least she's kind of entertaining to watch. Unlike you know who. Listen to the song called Deer in the Headlights by Owl City, because I think it perfectly sums up Marinette. Thank you guys so much for watching, it really means a lot. If you guys enjoyed watching, why not leave a like and a comment? Be sure to subscribe for more Ladybug videos. Stay cool, stay safe, and what day is it today? Oh, there's no holiday? Okay, well, happy day. I guess? Is that a thing?
Well, happy day! Happy day!
Oh, it's a thing? Really? Okay, well, stay cool, stay safe, and happy day, I guess. Whatever.